Hi everyone, Chase here from Proxlight. In this video, we are going to see how to get the real-time price of cryptocurrencies using Binance API in Python. A cryptocurrency is a digital currency designed to work as a medium of exchange through a computer network that is not reliant on any central authority, such as a government or bank, to uphold or maintain it. You can refer to our Hashnode article for a better understanding and a step-by-step guide to the same. Binance API is a method that allows you to connect to the Binance servers using several programming languages. With it, you can automate your trading and make HTTP requests send and receive data. Here we access Binance API using Python with the request module. We will be sending requests to Binance API and extracting the real-time price of the required cryptocurrency in JSON format. We will use the JSON module to convert extracted JSON data to a Python dictionary. With that being set, let's start coding. First of all, we will be importing modules like JSON and requests. Now we will be defining the request URL. In this case, it is api.binance.com. As you can note here, we have set the symbol, which stands for Bitcoin or Tether cryptocurrency price. You can replace it with DOGEUSDT, which simply means Dogecoin, in order to fetch the current prices. Here requests.get method will send a request to a specified URL and save it in data, and the .json method will convert data to a Python dictionary. In the end, we will be printing the current price using the print method under which we will be passing our dictionary. Let's see how to get multiple real-time crypto prices. The concept behind this chunk of code is the same, but instead of printing the data for single crypto, we will be making a list for multiple cryptos. Then we will be running for loop in the list, which is currencies in this case. While running the for loop, we will be concatenating the key with each list element in the currency. Make sure to increment the value of g by using g equals g plus 1. In the end, we will be printing the current price using the print method under which we will be passing our dictionary. Here is the output. I hope this was helpful to you, and if it was, then consider subscribing and hit the like button below. I will meet you in another video. Until then, keep coding.